What's up, you guys? Welcome back to the channel. I'm really excited for today's video. Finally coming at you with a nutrition style video this time. A lot of you have been requesting to see like what I eat in a day kind of thing. So yeah, today I thought I would share with you what I eat to stay lean. That's just my personal goal for lean muscle mass. That's what I train for. I do lift weights very often. So I tend to have more of a high protein, high natural fat intake, lots of complex carbs, things like that. So this is kind of just like an overall view of what I eat throughout the span of a day. We have a few varieties here, but this is just in a nutshell what I'm looking at. Again, this is what works for me and my body type. I have done nothing but trial and error for years. So this is what my body likes, what it needs and what it craves. So everybody's body is different, obviously, but this is just here to give you a little bit of inspiration or some new ideas of different things for you to try. I am going to note right here, right now, that I do not count calories. I do what's called like intuitive eating. I like to practice just kind of eating what I feel is necessary for my body. I like to listen to my body. So some days I might eat a little more calories than others. Some I don't feel like I need as much calories. So I just listen to my body, honestly. I don't count calories. The only mental note I kind of try to strive for is how much protein I'm intaking so that my gains can get maximized since I'm hitting those weights. I'm trying to get it, girl. I am. So if you're trying to get it, definitely hit that subscribe button. Follow your girl on IG for all things fitness because together we got this. Now let's go. We got some chit chat to do. All right, guys. So I typically wake up around like 6:30, 7 o'clock latest. First thing I like to do is grab myself a nice black cup of coffee. I don't put cream in it, I don't put sugar in it. I used to do that and I kind of slowly cut that out and now I just love the taste of black coffee. It hits straight where it needs to hit and it wakes me up and your girl's on fire for the rest of the day. Fun fact, black coffee with nothing else in it is a metabolism booster. So that's what I like to do, wake me up in the morning, and then when I'm ready, I usually eat one of three things. I have like a little variety. Some days I will go with the classic toast with eggs. I really, really love Dave's Killer Bread. I'm not a huge bread eater. I try to stay away from it, but Dave's Killer Bread is actually the leanest bread I've come to find. It is nutrition packed and they have such a variety of different flavors. I really like their thin slice. So I have like two thin slices in the morning. I like to eat a lot of carbs in the morning because I know really soon after I'm gonna be hitting some weights. I need that energy. I can't collapse at the gym. So we got thin sliced 21 whole grains with seeds and then raisin the roof because I like raisins. Organic bread, only 70 calories, like very good low carb. So it's great to get your carbs in, your protein with your eggs, and then I always have like a nice mandarin orange. I love these little baby clementines just to add in some sugar. I like to have a nice balance. So if I'm not feeling eggs, I'll usually just have a nice hot bowl of oatmeal. I just go with the classic plain oats, do it yourself kind of thing. I add in a little bit of organic honey, nothing crazy, just to sweeten it up. Blueberries, some banana if I'm feeling it. And I love to add in chia seeds because it's a really good source of protein. They actually help to make your hair shiny, fun fact. Yeah, so I like a nice hot cup of oats or I go with the classic shredded wheat, which is just plain shredded wheat. No sugar, no fancy cereal, and a little bit of honey just to sweeten it up so it's tolerable. I also use Planet Oat Milk. Like I said before, I do kind of stay away from the dairy thing. For me, I notice dairy bloats me. And that's the key to what I eat in a day is to kind of stay away from anything that will bloat me. So the most I will have like topping wise is a little bit of crushed pink Himalayan salt, but I go super light. I don't buy things with high sodium. My rule of thumb is going for things that have less than 100 milligrams of sodium on the label per serving. That's just what I like to bring into my place. Okay, I'm very picky with what I bring into the kitchen. It is dairy-free, it still has an excellent source of calcium, vitamins A and D, and I do take a multivitamin, so I'm not worried about like not getting the essential. So yeah, I noticed personally that staying away from dairy has significantly helped my bloat. I also notice I'm not breaking out as much. So whenever I eat cheese, I start getting these weird pimples all over my face. I'm just like, what the frick? So I just figure, whatever, man. Just cheese and I just, I guess we're not, as much as I love dairy, we're just not meant to be. And then I love to just add in berries. I love fresh berries like blueberries, strawberries, cherries, things like that. So as you can see, with anything I typically make, I will always have like fresh berries for antioxidants. It's a nice natural sugar to get your body in gear. I like energizing foods. I like superfoods and things like that. Nutrients are gonna help my body, help me lift at the gym and make me feel all right. So right after breakfast is when I like to take my CLA. I use InnoSup CLA 1200. CLA is made from safflower oil. So what it does is it helps your body composition. It helps me personally. I notice it helps to get rid of that excess bloat, excess water weight, because no matter how hard I train and how clean I eat, I can feel this like layer like in between me and my muscles. So I noticed taking CLA like religiously helps me feel just like shredded. But that's me personally, so absolutely love InnoSup CLA. Dope. So as you can tell already that everything that I eat usually is just a bunch of ingredients combined. That's typically more of the non-processed route to take. Things that are usually instant, like all in one, have a lot of unnecessary ingredients that are just processed and not really that great to put into your body. So I just have a bunch of things that I just pop together to make it just healthy and well-rounded. All right, guys, so I am the kind of person who eats breakfast right away. So 8 o'clock, I'm like done eating already and moving on with the day. I usually hit the gym around 10 o'clock-ish. So beforehand, I gotta eat something else. So we got some snackaroos. These are what I pick on throughout the day. So when it's snack time, this is my go-to in between my meals. Number one, nuts. That's what she said. I like to pick on sunflower seeds. I just love the flavor. They're hard to eat, but I love them. Almonds are another good one. My favorite is actually banana with peanut butter. This is gonna hold you over the longest. I notice when I eat this before workout, I have energy. I don't get hungry for a long time. Peanut butter with the natural fat really will help satiate hunger for an extended period of time. So when in doubt, nut it out. Eat the nuts. I do not go crazy with the snacks before the gym, but everything that I do have here is so super light that it's not something that's gonna make me go, oh God, I'm so full. It's not a full meal. So I also like to have cut up vegetables. Here's a big thing. Cut up celery, baby carrots, things that are accessible. Whenever I buy celery stalks, I always cut them up right away in little baby chunks so that it's easy to pick and grab, because if I don't, then I will not eat it. I'll just see the stalk in my fridge and it'll be there until it goes bad. So little tip, cut that up. I love these rice cakes from Whole Foods. They are organic. There's a little bit of sugar in it, just a little bit, cane sugar. It's like cinnamon flavor. Mm, love it. It's from the brand Lundberg, okay? Organic whole grain rice cakes. They have a lot of different flavors. I like to eat them plain or with peanut butter. I'm a big peanut butter gal. Hummus is another thing I like to eat a little bit here and there. If I'm kind of tired of peanut butter, I will pick on hummus, which is basically made out of chickpeas. But always be mindful of the label. I always check the sodium. So the hummuses that I buy, things like that, or anything for that sake, will always have a low sodium so I don't retain water. And speaking of water, I drink water throughout the day when I first wake up. With every single meal, that's pretty much all I drink other than black coffee. Just lots of water. I try to drink my body weight in ounces for the day. That's my goal. Gotta keep hydrated so that your body doesn't confuse hunger with just being dehydrated. A lot of people think that the more water that you drink, the more your body's gonna retain it, but that's not actually true. Your body retains a lot when you're dehydrated because it's in starvation mode. It is holding on to the water because it doesn't know when it's gonna get water next. So if you keep your body like a fueled machine and just keep drinking a lot of water throughout the day, you're naturally gonna shed more water weight because your body isn't holding on to it for dear life. And lastly, when it comes to snacks, this is actually a recent find. I love it. The past few weeks, J. James and I have been eating a lot of Lara bars. They are great. These are the only real like packaged things that we eat, like little grab and go things that we will bring with us if we're out for the day. These are so simple. There's only 5 ingredients in them. They are mostly made out of dates. Okay, so really good for fiber. If you have trouble in the bathroom, we have a lot of different flavors here. They're delicious. You got blueberry, cherry pie, apple, like anything you can think of, absolutely delicious. So drop a comment if you've tried these Lara bars. Let me know what your favorite flavor is. I think mine's cherry pie or blueberry muffin. All right guys, so right after the gym is when I like to have like my post-workout snacks, things you just saw pretty much, and hop into lunch. But sometimes James and I actually go out photo shooting, we're out for the day working. This is right around the time after the gym when we like to get cracking and get working for the day. So that brings us to our sponsor for today's video, IsoBag. Thank you so much. This baby is a freaking monster. It has been such an awesome addition to our lifestyle. So IsoBag pretty much specializes in meal prep bags. They come in a variety, so single person, if you just need just you for the day. This baby is actually for 2 people for the entire day. It can hold like 6 meals. Or if you're just one person and you need it for 6 meals, then this could be your own bag. But I specifically got the large one for James and I when we're out photo shooting for the day or out and about. Or to be honest with you, going to my family's house, sometimes they don't eat the best and I really don't want to fall off my regimen. So I like to bring my own food. They're probably sick of me doing that, but whatever. You gotta keep the gains, girl. Sorry, you just do. So this bag is dope because you have not only a lot of cool compartments, but it comes with everything you will need. You got your ice packs. You have all the meal prep containers you will ever need. You have the smaller size and then you have larger sizes. Let me tell you, this baby seals up so nicely. Believe me, I've had things like on its side, like turned different ways, and nothing has leaked. And your girl uses nothing but freaking olive oil for all her meals. Nothing, nothing. So it snaps shut, and then when you want to open it, you just kind of press down in the middle and then pop it up on the sides here. These babies are BPA free, which is obviously like I stand by that. They are dishwasher safe. You can freeze them. These babies have endured a lot and they did not crack. Nothing's like, I didn't have to throw any of them out. It's definitely high qual for sure. Love this freaking bag. Okay, look at this. This is like one big duffel bag. Okay. So like I said before, they do come in a variety of sizes, but they also come in a variety of colors. I got the black on black. I like that look, nice and sleek. So it does come with an adjustable strap, a little lock up here to keep things nice and tidy. You have a flap like right here, nice mesh holder right here. You can put things like forks, knives, napkins, things like that. You also have a nice spot right up here. You can put ice packs up here or additional food storage, up to you. Me personally, if I'm really busy for the day, I like to put like my phone and things like that up here so that everything's with me. I don't have like all these bags hanging around. This kind of does it all for me. You also have a front zipper right here. Boom! That opens up and it's easy grab and go. You're not like digging in this way. You could just grab your meal prep out of here. So there's plenty of room. You could fit all your containers in here as well as the ice packs, which you could kind of mix and match where you need it. Then we got the side compartments. You could put your water bottles. This fits an entire blender bottle in here. You also have a zipper here. So in case it's something that you don't want sloshing around or falling out, boom, and it zips shut. And you not only have this on one side, but you have it on the other side too. So one for me, one for Bae, all right? Just how I like it. I don't like sharing things with him. The IsoBag is the number one meal prep bag on the market, made right here in the USA. I can tell because it's amazing. So again, huge thank you to IsoBag for sponsoring this portion of today's video. I am in love, thank you. Best addition to our lifestyle, and I'm sorry, but it really helps me not to binge on fast food when I'm out and I'm hangry. I'm gonna be real with you. This is a necessity for me and my lifestyle, so heck yeah. After my workout, if I'm just hanging home, got no photo shoots to go on, I always have my post-workout protein shake, for real. Like I said, trying to maximize those gains, I need that freaking protein. So I love this freaking protein by InnoSups. It's the Hot Cocoa Crunch Advanced ISO Protein, 25 grams per serving. So good. It has little baby crunchies in it. So it's like, ugh, it tastes just like hot cocoa. It's legit. So yeah, just one scoop of this with the oat milk that you saw before to add in that little extra creamy texture, you know? It is good. I feel it. It fuels up my muscles. I need it. So I also like to eat something with my protein shake, okay? I'm a big eater, like especially after the workout. I am usually hangry at this point. So here's what my typical go-to. I like to eat a lot of vegetables. As you can see, you need that fiber. You need the micronutrients. So I like to have like a nice little baby garden salad with sunflower seeds, tomato, cucumber, oil and vinegar. Usually I just try to keep it really simple. I absolutely love to pick on edamame. I actually eat this as a snack like throughout the day when I'm editing. In case you have never tried edamame, it's like they're little pea pods, they're little edamame in this like furry little shell. I know that sounds disgusting, but they're fun to eat. And I like to use this to keep me busy while I'm editing. They're fun to eat. Then I like to have a nice wrap. Nice tuna wrap, fresh. A little bit of olive oil and pink Himalayan salt. That's all I really need. Some tomato, maybe some onion diced up, whatever. The kind of tuna that I buy is in a can, but it doesn't have like the excess like oils and stuff. It is just in water. Whenever there's oils and stuff like that, it's just usually they're not very good oils. The kind of wraps that I like is the multi-grain Tumeros carb-wise, because there's barely any carbs in it. And the sodium's good, real good. You are looking at only 120 milligrams of sodium per wrap, okay, in the hundreds. Some have like 600-700 a wrap, like it's disgusting. So definitely be mindful of that. So as you can see, I do have bursts of carbs throughout the day. So I am trying to gain some lean muscle mass up in here. So these are really good because they don't overdo it for me, all right, carb-wise. So what I've been really into lately are sweet potato fries. Homemade sweet fries are so freaking good. I just sizzle them in olive oil, extra virgin olive oil with a little bit of pink Himalayan salt, and they are so stinking tasty. Ooh! So I love sweet potatoes, but I like them even more when they're in French fry form. I'm just saying. So I like to have them on the side or maybe for dinner. They're delicious. These are very awesome complex carbs right here. So this could work as a little pre-workout snack if you'd like. So everything here is pretty much super lean. You got the edamame, which is very, very, very high in protein. I am a huge fan of plant protein. Even though I'm not vegetarian, I still eat a lot of plant-based protein. All right, guys, now it's my favorite time of the day, dinner time, baby. Yes. So I tend to steer away from red meats. I will eat them occasionally, like once in a blue moon, but I typically eat fish, chicken, and sometimes turkey. Sometimes. I'm not really a huge fan of chicken, I'm gonna be real with you. So when I do eat chicken, it's lean grilled chicken breast and it's sauteed in some serious flavors because I think grilled chicken is nasty. So what we got going on here, which I really like, by the way, Bay, I gotta give him props for prepping all this food because it never looks this good. He did it specifically to wow you guys today. But if you saw the way we really make it, it looks nasty. So here we go. What I love to eat is a nice, fresh piece of salmon. I don't like frozen because it tastes too freaking fishy. I don't like fishy fish. So lean salmon is literally game central. You will be a lean beast eating salmon. Omega-3 fatty acids for life. I love to add in my fresh basil that you'll see back here. We got fresh basil, rosemary, and cilantro. We always add them into our dinners and our lunches. I love eating this on like a bed of brown rice with green beans. For some reason, salmon and green beans is just my go-to. So nothing like a fresh piece of salmon with basil. Oh my God, are you kidding me? Whew. Add in some garlic, absolutely, yes. Next, what we eat like nonstop is red lentil pasta. If you've been watching my channel for a while, you would know I'm literally obsessed with red lentil pasta. Again, with the plant-based protein, so super, super dope complex carbs for you to incorporate into your diet. So I obviously don't eat like white starches and things like that. Try to keep it super lean. So the red lentil spaghetti from Barilla is life. It is literally made out of one ingredient and one ingredient only, and that is red lentil flour. We like to make it sauteed with garlic, a little bit of olive oil, and I've been really loving to add in grilled shrimp. Again, here we go. I'm super picky with the grilled shrimp that I buy. It has to be lower sodium shrimp because you wouldn't even believe some of the bags of shrimp, the serving size, they can go like 600-700 milligrams of sodium per serving. So I always like to go with more, not necessarily fresh. I don't buy fresh shrimp. I like it frozen because I like to eat it throughout the week, but I go for like lower sodium. They're out there. You just gotta look for it. Whole Foods, to my knowledge, has the best so far when it comes to finding low sodium shrimp. But I'm still on the scout for other brands. So yes, shrimp with red lentil penne is my favorite. And then over here, oh my God, if there's something I love, it's Mexican style food. I love a little bit of spice. I love cilantro. It's so good. So here we have like shredded up chicken. All right, this is the only way I can eat my chicken is when there's a lot of other things going on involved here. We got some peppers. It's cilantro and salsa. We actually buy our salsa already made, but it's always the fresh salsa. Again, a lot of the pre-made salsas have nothing but sodium in it, but if you find the real fresh stuff, it's just freshly made, clean, nothing but clean, fresh ingredients. So we basically put the chicken in and then we add on some salsa. We put homemade guacamole that we like to make, just chop up some avocados and add in some delicious seasonings, garlic powder, things like that. Some cilantro from our little herb garden over here, a little bit of lime, some peppers, and some black beans we like to add in too. So you make your own little Mexican dish. I also really love to add in some hot sauce, Texas Pete hot sauce. It's nice. It's a really nice addition. Hot sauces are usually for the most part clean. Always check the label. So this one definitely does it for me. Very clean and definitely helps to up your metabolism a little bit. Hot stuff, okay? Get your blood pumping. And please note that I don't just stick to the serving size when I eat. I eat until I feel content. That's my rule, okay? So I don't limit myself when it comes to like eating. If I feel hungry, I will eat. I never ignore my body. So when I say refer to the label, I just mean that's something I reference as a rule of thumb, so I know what to purchase and bring into here. It's just my guideline that I go by. It's not like I just stick here and only go by the serving size. I will not do that. I will not count calories. I wanna actually enjoy my food and enjoy my healthy lifestyle. So if I gotta count everything, which there's definitely a reason why people count calories, but it's just not for me, my lifestyle, period. I just need to feel free a little bit, you know? I don't care how healthy I'm trying to be. You know that you get that like desire. So do I. So usually I'll have popcorn. That is my thing. I will never, I mean never, exclude popcorn because I'm obsessed with it. So we do not buy like the pre-made bags with the butter and the salt and everything like that. We actually make our own stovetop popcorn. It's so delicious. We just get like the loose kernels here. Extra virgin olive oil, layer the bottom. Put that shiz on high. Sprinkle in some pink Himalayan salt and pop it. Put the salt on before it pops. So it tastes so similar to movie theater popcorn. I actually got my mom hooked on it. It's definitely a lot better for you. It actually holds you over because you got some olive oil up in that gut of yours. So it is really a great snack that I like to eat at night watching some TV. If I'm craving some freaking chocolate, which your girl, she craves it like a lot, okay? Lindt Excellent has been some of the cleanest chocolate I've ever seen. Dark chocolate, 85% cocoa. It is more bitter than a lot of chocolates out there, but that is because it is made of mostly cocoa, which is an antioxidant, a superfood, great for your heart health. So chocolate, little pieces a day are actually super, super healthy for you to incorporate. So I have a few pieces a day. Sometimes I will add in some peanut butter again because who doesn't love chocolate with peanut butter? The peanut butter that I buy is the Smucker's Natural Chunky. The creamy actually has a lot more sodium, so that's why I go with the chunker. It is the kind of peanut butter with the oil on top, which is super annoying, but it's usually a lot cleaner than other peanut butters that just doesn't separate. Like, peanut butter is supposed to freaking separate. Put it that way. So, sandwich together some peanut butter and a couple of these babies. You got yourself some deliciousness for real. So keep this in the refrigerator. All right, guys, so that was it. That was what I like to eat to stay lean. Again, everybody is different and responds to food differently. So this is just what I like to eat and incorporate into my daily routine. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you do have any questions, obviously comment down below and let's chit chat it up. Don't forget to subscribe if you have not already. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll catch you in my next video.